perspective for why it is, and also a fresh lima to your nephew, Bezat Hashem. So, oh Hashem, I'm very happy because for 1 year when we're doing Ilula, I give everybody time to speak. Everybody speak, I have 1 hour of speech of limud.
Wow, 20 minutes.
It means that the Chochmah is entering more. And I hope that one day we start the Ilula like this, we make a pause for Mincha and we continue after. We say, okay, we have to give space to everybody. So I will just, amen. Je veux juste qu'on considère une situation. I would like to consider one situation. Everybody, when you talk about Moshe, it's Moshe was humble. Quand on parle de Moshe, c'est Moshe, il était humble. So, if you say that it's the fact, give me the proof. Si tu me dis que c'est la vérité, donne-moi les preuves. Eh bien, Nathan, give me a proof that Moshe was humble.
This is one of the reasons why I said I do not know much more about Moshe, but through the Torah I can relate.
No, I want fact. It's written that he was humble. Torah is full of stories. You have all the Tanakh, Gemara, Midrashim, Mishnayot. I want one example that you know, which will be the proof that Moshe was humble. Je veux un exemple, une preuve que Moshe était humble.
So many probably he was captured by his own sister, his own brother, they give salad.
It's not the proof of humble, this. Can you afraid?
Okay.
He didn't look at the snack.
The?
Like, he didn't look at the thorns. He didn't look at the fire. The flaming bush. He could have looked at the Shekhinah.
Is it the prophet of Amaldis?
His eyes were hurt.
What about
when Hashem said, you do away with everybody else and I make a nation out of you?
I got it. When Hashem says, we accept. Mm-hmm. But let's talk to our level, our dimension. I want proof.
Yeah.
The way I learned it is that why Moshe was humble? What is humility? Humility is not like, for example.
So you're giving your definition of humility?
No.
Okay.
It was a proof inside the Torah.
Is that he knew he was great. He knew he had the Torah, he was great. But one thing he also understood is that had somebody else had it, he would have done better than him.
Where's the proof? You give drashot. I want proof. I can give proof on Avram. I can give proof on Yitzhak. I can give proof on Yaakov. I can give proof. Give me one about Moshe.
I got one. It could be drash.
Yeah.
You correct me on that. So there's a commentary Baal Shem Tov did on the book of Exodus, and he says that Moshe, when Hashem first came to him, told him, you're going to be the leader, you're going to take them out, the whole thing. And he said the reason why Moshe was able to accept maybe that he was fitting to be this person, he said because he was standing on Mount Sinai, and Mount Sinai was the smallest mountain surrounded by all these humongous mountains. It was the smallest mountain, right? And he says, well, if Hashem can choose this mountain to bring the Torah, which is the smallest round around much greater mountains, so too could I, being a small person, accept the Torah.
It's not the proof. It's a drash.
It is a drash.
We are analyzing a situation with interpretation of that situation that it was like this.
So the Torah says it's the proof. No? The race it says.
Yes, but when we talk, when you say like this, about Avram, we say Avram was opening his tent huge to people. We said, come eat. When we talk about the fact that he won the war and the king of them say, okay, he said, no, don't give me anything. Even a chut, I don't know what. So I just want one proof.
And from Midrash is okay?
I would just want one proof.
I think he said that when when Moshe realized that Yeshua was going to be his heir, that he went and stood in the doorway while Yeshua was learning, and he stood there like people stand mm-hmm. while Moshe is sitting to give his psak, showing that he's his rabbi now. It wasn't just that he's going to be everyone else's.
Finish the midrash.
And then you're going to, okay.
What comes after the midrash? He said he stood 1 hour, and after he went to Hashem, say, I cannot. He said, I cannot take me back. Where's the openness?
Okay, what about when Moshe saw Rabbi Akiva?
Yes.
And he saw Rabbi Akiva, and mm-hmm. he's just like, why am I even here? Look what this guy is about to do.
So this is humbleness?
It may not be. It's not. There's no proof.
What about when Hashem told him he's not going to enter the land?
Yeah.
But he still talked to people, knowing that they were going to enter the land, even though they weren't.
Talk to them. Say, because of you, I'm not entering. Because of you, I'm not entering. Because of you. All the parasha is accusing people.
Rabbi.
That's humbleness.
Can you say, like, for example?
First of all, what is humbleness?
Thank you.
This
is the beginning. What is humbleness? Because if we define it according to our knowledge, believe me, you will not find a fact. You'll find drashot, remez. You'll find many things, but a fact, it will be hard to find it. So what is that humbleness that we talk? And he said, this is like that.
Mm.
Because even Aaron and Miriam, their own brother and sister, they have big doubt on him. We say, you made strange fish in Kush. That's why you're not entering there. So if they, as brother and sister, prophets, have doubt on him, who are we to say? Moshe was humble. What did you say?
Est-ce que l'unité,
c'est la sagesse aussi? Est-ce que c'est connecté ensemble? Yeah, Nava and Chokhmah, yes. But let's build it together. Because we need that tools, on a besoin de cet outil-là, to apply what you have just said, Rabbi Mordechai, before. We're going to go fast, so please just follow. Any question, feel free. Zohar Balak, something we have already seen, un truc qu'on a déjà vu, un truc qu'on a déjà vu, mais on va essayer de le voir d'une autre manière. It's all about the first thing, the hatred that the Midianim, they have against Moshe. La haine que les Midianim, ils ont contre Moshe. Because the guy will become the master of the world. He was just here in our country. We could have stopped it. Donc, c'est Rabbi Shimon. You have to know that all the story when they will send the prostitutes to bring the king, the son of the king, the son of Israel to sin. Who had the idea? Midian. Qui avait l'idée, Midian, d'envoyer des prostituées pour que les enfants d'Israël tombent. Al-Moshe. He said, my purpose wasn't on all the people of Israel. It was not on Israel. It was only on Moshe. All the sage of Midian, all the priests, target was, we have to bring this man to fall. Mm. But which Moshe is in Midian? It's not the Moshe, like, at the level of the Ten Makot.
Mm.
It's a Moshe who was 10 years in jail in Yitro's place. Why you target the guy? Pourquoi tu te focalises sur lui? He said all the purpose was to touch him. And he said, so in the advice, they talked to Bilam. So Bilam, and they said, we will pay you. We just want you to curse him. Or juste que tu le maudisses. So when they saw that Bilam couldn't make any curse, because of it, Bilam était coincé. La crew et a cheret la tzma bekpidu neseem bebenoteem yoter mi moav share al neshot midian katuv hen inea yu livne israel veakol aya mi bidian. So he said, what they decided to do, I share with you the text, but I pull the text. They decided to send their own wives and their own daughter to prostitute and to bring Moshe to sin. A whole country, tout un pays, a whole kingdom, just want you to see that nakedness and to fall. This is their purpose. C'est leur but. Oh, let's start to define humbleness. You cannot be humble if you don't know how to handle your brit milah.
Mm.
You can say what you want. Herbert is this, mountain eye, not taking the position, removing the, I got you. No, Rabbi Shimon said, calm down. I'm the giggle of Moshe. Can we wish to Moshe? I'm telling you, if no one puts you on target, say, oh, this is the doll, Rabbi Nathan, you know, when they do voodoo. Rabbi Nathan, we send to you one Latina, two Latina, three Latina. Oh. Hey. No, that's why I'm telling you, the name. If you cannot handle this, you are not humble. Si tu peux pas gérer ça, t'as pas d'humilité. Building humbleness on only feelings that, no, you know, I can stay calm. This is the fake humbleness of the philosopher. Real humbleness, la vraie humilité, ne peut se construire qu'avec la gdusha de la Brit Mila. Can only be built on the kedusha of Brit Mila. That's why you see that Moshe was the man, like Rabbi Zohar, Rabbi Mordechai, connected to the Tet. Target. That's why everyone wants to be a leader. Everyone want to manage project. Know that if you're really sincere and really connected to Moshe, then he will send to you. They will send to you. This is a part of the game. First thing. But now the question is, how Moshe did so fast that humbleness? Because we left you, you grew up in the house of a king, and we know it's very hard for a prince to be humble. Because you receive many before even one proof that you are someone. Because you reçois beaucoup avant même de prouver que tu es quelqu'un. You have the service, the servants, the maids, everything. So it's much more harder for a son of a king to become humble than to a poor man. Because what is your fight? Nothing, just have to fight to find the bread. So you will be humble. What reason do you have to become Gava? No reason. T'as pas de raison d'être Gava. So when poverty helps you to stay humble. But how can you be in humbleness when you are the level of son of a king, house of a king, king? How can you build it? This is the beginning. But when did he get that power? Comment, à quel moment est cette force-là? Because the Torah said, if you are a murderer, if you murder people, si tu tues des gens, for sure your Brit Mila is weak.
Oh.
It's connected, yes.
What?
That's why when losing, see, this is called being murdered. So if someone is a killer, quelqu'un c'est un meurtrier, don't run. You know that the life which comes with is full of immorality. Tu sais que la vie qui vient avec est plus d'immoralité. So what's happened? The savior of the Jewish people is a killer Egyptian. You cannot handle your anger. Think about the consequences of your act. You just kill the guy. You prove that you are not ready because after you run away. If it's on the plan, stay with your people and face the situation. Si c'est un plan, tue-le, reste là et fais face à la situation. But look, Yakut Shimoni. Allez, Yakut Shimoni.
This is Makom Lesha.
Yes. Yakut Shimoni.
Why are you humble? Because you don't want to damage your Brit Mila. Why is that humble?
Because Rabbi Nechunya gave us the keys yesterday. You have Yud Kev Raf.
Yeah.
You complete. If you damage that place, it means that you think about yourself, not about the others. Well, then at least the three letters are standing on your Brit Mila. You see them, you say, okay, no. It's not about me only. It's about more than me. I have to be on the Hoshen. I have to be a part of the tribes. I have to play my role. This is humbleness. You can be very ambitious and being humble. There's no problem. But always see if you know how to protect his interest. Regarde comment tu sais si tu peux garder ses intérêts. But Moshe had the key, the biggest test ever. What will bring him to being that man full of anger and can kill, to a man who will say, you know what, erase my name from your book. You may give that example, proof of humbleness. You cannot do humbleness by testing God. Hashem. What is that humbleness? I'll raise my name of your book. No, say, you know what? If you don't want to take my name, just raise me because I don't say from your book. Why are you doing that things? But look, one event was the key moment for Moshe Rabbeinu to become who he became. It was when he arrived with the king of Cush in the desert. Look what he said. He said like this. Daf Ein Hashbet, Ein Hashbet here. First of all, the king of Cush is strange. Has a very strange name. That king who was on the place when Moshe arrived from his escaping. So what a language bizarre. Sometimes he is called Kuknus. Sometimes called Kiknus. Sometimes Vav. Sometimes it's Yud. So we have the name of the king who was in place before Moshe arrived to be king. On a le nom du roi. We, like said the sage, the Torah never gives the name for free. La Torah n'a jamais un nom gratuitement. Sometimes we pass millions of people don't give a single name. They say, wives, daughters, and sons. Okay, give one name. No. And suddenly we have in the Yakut Shimonit, and the sage said, you know what? The name of that king was Kuknus or Kiknus. So look what he said. He said, I'll read the final verse because I have the statement going. Ve'yilachem et Edom ve'et b'nei Kedem ve'et Aram ve'et Yechani'im tachat yad b'nei Kush. So he said basically, Moshe, being the king of Cush, he fight everybody. Il a combattu tout le monde étant roi de Cush. Everybody. Bnei Kedem, the Edom, the all the people who were basically under the domination of Cush. Tout le monde. And he said, Ve'yami Masher Malar al Bnei Cush, and the year he was king on the son of Cush. C'est les années qu'il était roi sur Bnei Cush. Arbaim Shana, 40 years, 40 ans. Ve'yatzliyah bekol milchamto. And he was successful in all the wars, all the battles. Which battles? Hey. Many battles he did as a king. Many battles. It means that you just find the name of Moshe in the time of the Cush kingdom, you will see. This name I don't give because I don't want problem now. I keep it in a small property. Find this name and you will see, won that battle. See, all the war, it was successful. Like I did in the guerre. Ki Hashem Elohe Avotav Ito, because Hashem was with him. I have the first sign here. We know from the Ilchot Kohanim that only the Kohanim are sent to war.
What?
Yes. Send the Kohanim to war? T'envoie les prêtres à la guerre. Because to win war, you need what?
Blessing.
Holiness of Brit Mila.
Why?
Yeah, it's done. Proof. You have only victories. I don't know any country like that. You win, sometimes you lose. You can lose one battle, and after we do what, but a few battles in and there. Every single thing, he win. This is the proof of his humbleness. Ah, strange, right? Mm-hmm. The proof of his humbleness was all the victory he had in the wars. Yes, we got it. La preuve de toute son humilité, c'est toutes les victoires qu'il a dans sa guerre. Dans les guerres. And after 40 years,
of Israël, où Yoshev Al-Kiso is sitting on his chair, on his throne. Il est assis sur son trône. Kisa Menucha, Vigbir Veyoshevet Leyamino Eslo, Batomer Agvira, Vagvira Yashvet Yamino. So he said, he was sitting after 40 years, and the wife, the queen he married, was sitting on his right. Elle était assise à sa droite, sa femme. And she said to the ministers, and to the people. So it's strange. Are you standing on the right of someone and talking to the others? Talk to him. Parle à lui, pourquoi tu parles aux autres? What does she say? Qu'est-ce qu'elle dit? Veine, ze arbaim shana, asher mala, ze al kush. Your husband, you call him Ze? Your husband for 40 years, you call him Ze? It says after 40 years, the districts is raining on Kush. This thing. Cette chose-là, il règne. Malar Ze. And he said, Al Kush, Ve'elai lo karav. I never came close to me. Il s'est jamais rapproché de moi. Et he never served the God of the son of Cush. Il n'a jamais servi le Dieu de Bnei Cush. Don't, not Elohim. You have one God. Who is that God? Huh? I don't know.
Wait, doesn't Ben Ishchai say Zeh Zeh HaShulchan?
Yeah, there's many drush on Zeh. You can... All of them taking
the place. Are we saying that it's a disrespect?
It's yours, but you call him Zeh.
Is Zeh HaShulchan?
Malar HaMeler, Malar HaBen Adam HaZeh, Malar HaIsh HaZeh, Malar... Why you say Zeh?
The Shulchan.
Even the Buddha say, I didn't say Zeh on the Buddha, I said the Buddha. And he said... You never say Rachel talk about Yaakov say Zeh. Sarah to about talking about Abraham say Zeh. Leah talking about Yaakov say Zeh. All the wives of David say Zeh. You never see that.
Because he's a king,
Before you go to the Drash, let's take the pshat. Understand the text. You go to the Drash, of course I can bring positive negative from everything. I can say 1,000 argue that it's positive to Zeh and 1,000 it's negative. We can go on it, but let's understand. It's your husband. Why use that language?
Context,
yes. Because if you don't analyze like this, you miss many information is the way. Before you bring your drash, bring, understand what's happening here, because you will do the biggest mistake ever. She will say, tell him to go. What? He's blessing the country. We are blessed from Hashem. We never lose any battle you ask us to say to this man to go. And then now they will be afraid to ask to him. So does this negative? See? Like he said, Bnei Kush, lo avad, ve'ata, shamuna b'ni Kush. Now what she said? Listen to me, son of Kush. Écoutez moi, les enfants de Kush. Ve'lo imlor alechem ze. And that ze will not rain on you again. Et ce ze va plus durer sur vous. What I'm telling you now is the most painful story of African people. Because Hashem never decided to remove Moshe from our leadership. We decided by our own. But we decided by the voice of the queen. Like we said in the morning, the Pia. Look. We say, Ine'e, Munachem, Ebene'im, Lo. So say, put my son on the place now. Mettez mon fils à la place. What's his name? Munacham. Munacham. The same letter, yes. Munacham. Check. Munacham, king of Kush. Check. Cherchez. Say Munacham will be the king. Alechem. Kitov lachem. Because it's good for you. Oh. Now understand that even the words are codes also. Is there a moment that the people don't deserve the king? Yes.
It's not only that you have bad king. No, the people's level also define what kind of king you deserve. So what happened after 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 20 victories? What do you think? You think you are America? We are the number one of the world. No one can beat us. Ah, arrogancy? Let him go. Because you don't deserve him anymore. Put my son. When you experience greatness and you don't know how to keep it, greatness went away from you for a long time. Till 2022, Africa still look after his greatness. He had the best one. 40 years of good job, 40 ans de travail parfait, and it's a phase. Because of what?
Success.
No. Success is a good thing. The question is, what do you do with? Mitzrayim had no problem with success. They had a very long and powerful domination on the world. The only mistake is that story of that amount of people that they considered it was theirs and didn't want to let them go. And according to what we saw in the story, Mitzrayim, it's more the black American. Yeah. They know how to handle success.
Right.
They build from it. We, Nekush, don't put success in front of us.
We continue the history.
Yes. We know, we all have that uncle. You said to him $1,000 for a project, he finished, he make for a wife. Right? He's the king.
Eat the money.
You finish the money. Even your parents grew you up, you know, don't work with your brother. Except if you go there and you live there. Why? It's in the DNA. That success or that smell of success. Some people, even you don't give anything, just give a small letter that, okay, we're going to start a company on diamond in 1 year. He saw that, you know what? I will be the boss. So you better marry me now. Stay next to me. You know, we know, it's story, story. People build life on fake information.
Oh my God.
Just they sell you success. Yes, the problem is here. So the Queen of Kush did well. You say, you know what? You don't deserve him. If you continue to act like this, him on your top, you bring on you gain up. So it's better for you to get my son, who is more than the Ze. And like this, it's done. She's playing with me. She's called him Ze to say, you know, it has no value, but no value to your eyes because you're blind by the success. Look at the president in Africa. We have oil. We have gold. We have diamonds. Look at your country. We have barely roads. Why are you screaming? Look, there's no electricity everywhere, no water, and you have the power to stand in front and say, here, I have this. What do you have? People don't eat, no school. 20% of your teenagers there don't know how to do it alphabet. And you say you have oil.
That's it comes to Band of Malawi. And it was a Bushandus of Angola. Bushandus took power in 1978. Malawi. Kamuzu Banda took power for 32 years. And they have been until Shamora of Mozambique decided to wage war on him because he sees himself as Hitler.
Oh my gosh.
He said, you are a great fascist guy. You need to go to hell like anybody else. We need to replace you. But the South Africans, because he was supported by South Africans, they decided to end the life of Samora. Wow. They ended his life in 1986.
Yes. So what the problem is now, on voit que tout le problème était la gestion du succès. But Moshe acquired all his humbleness by being in that position. Because it's easy to keep your yesod clean when you're on the diesel running away. But 40 years surrounded by people to tell you, we made it. You see that war? Look at the gun we have. We finish in one day. Now your gun is good. And you stay calm. You say, guys, what's wrong with you? It's nothing. It's nothing compared to compare to where I'm bringing you. But Hashem say, no, not them. Like Abraham said, no, not your daughter.
Equatorial Guinea, when they discovered petrol and the metal, other kind of metal, they keep the old man, the stupid old man.
Yes.
And his son went to Paris to buy shoes.
Yeah,
I know. Big collection of shoes.
This is that. And this is the curse of Kush. Management of success. We don't know. If we knew, we may see. But we don't see. We don't know. But the Mitzrayim, they don't know. If we succeed to connect both sides of Atlantic, what should be done? The best, go and study at Harvard, Yale. Study, do things. No, this is the bad scenario. The good one, come and study Botina Kadisha.
We can do everything. We can buy shoes.
So let's see, we finished. והם לא עליהם בזה, ולעבוד את הבן אדוניכם מעבור איש נוחי, זה because he's a נוחי, he's a stranger for us, זה הנתראי פורנו, והיא כל העם נדעון על הרב וישכימו, ובבוקר, אם לחוסר, it's strange, all the night they were talking, what should we do with that word in the key of the queen, at the bokeh, at the morning, a fine, good deal. It means that it wasn't unanimous. C'était pas unanimité. Meaning, side of Kush, some of them say, no, we do have problem now, guys. And the other part of this, let's say, of the humblest like us, we fight to say, no, you have to study, you have to do that. Don't care, don't pay attention to this and that.
Situation.
It was a fact. It is a fight inside of Kush. How can you let go the best ever? Comment tu peux dépasser le meilleur? Mashiach is your king. People will starve 6 million to get it. You get it straight. And you just buy shoes. Tu achètes des chaussures and you make it popular? So now look at what's up and finish. So basically, Kuknus. If you call Kiknus, it's Gematria 3:26. Kush. Strange. Wow. Why does the king has a name in Gematria of his tribe? And if it's, no, what is Kiknus? It's 3:36. When it's Kuknus, is 3:22. Kolel of Kolel of Shardini. Mm-hmm. We are again in the back of Chochmah. Mm-hmm. So look now what's happened. The back of Chochmah is the origin of the creation of the seed. Mm-hmm. L'ayat de la Chochmah, c'est le début de la création du Zera. So all the story here is about the tikkun of midot. We need not to give, to slap people with the midot. Don't look for anything else. We know you. You will get it fast. We know you are spiritual. Was that spiritual, the African American? We know you are spiritual, but we will slap you with the midot. 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 Change. Midot. Why? Only the midot will bring you to handle this part. And to finish, why do we connect to Moshe in this place through the doors of the seven kings? Pourquoi on connecte à Moshe par la dimension de ces trois? Because the seven kings are the feminine waters, so les eaux féminines. And what are the feminine waters? 52, Ban. What is Ban? Benayahu. What is Ban? Eliyahu. That is Ban, Caleb. All these names connected to 52. Now look what we are building here. What is going to construct here? Arakadosh Shara Gilgulim. Arakadosh Shara Gilgulim, he said. He did comme ça. He did. Vegan Benyan Elianavi, Zan. Amarli Morizala, Arakadosh told me. כי הנה הוא נרמז בפסוק אל סלליים ולהעיס ולהניעים יתען חן. שתיבות אליהו, so it's the פסוק where we have אליהו in the שתיבות. Okay. ועניין הוא, כמו שאמר כתוב זה לשונו בספר הזוהר. It's a look what's in the ספר הזוהר. כי משה רבנו היה רבן של כל ישראל. משה רבנו was the king, the teacher of all Israel. Was the teacher of Israel, l'enseignant de tout Israël. And he said, Ve, ametorgeman shelo, this one was explaining his word, Aya Aaron HaKohen, was Aaron HaKohen. Ve kshemoshe aya yelecha la pe, le fi shemesh aya, so say, it's said like this because Moshe had that problem with the call, and it was hard for him to speak. So Aaron was supposed to
speak.
No, to translate. Strange. What does this mean? Even if you are burned, I can understand you say. Without any more kichad shalom, you are too fatigued. Understand. I say, I'm tired. Right. What do I need, translator? I need just someone to explain what I'm saying. No, it's a translator.
He was speaking the language of Kush.
Wait, we got it.
But how would Aaron know it?
Ubecharit, ayamim, at the end of the days, in the generation of Mashiach, the generation of Mashiach, Yavu Moshe be Gilgul. Moshe will come in Gilgul. Be Yilamed Torah l'Israel, will teach Torah to all Israel again. וגם אז יהיה ערל פתיים. So also, his mouth will be ערל. You know what is ערל פתיים? And chew off the mouth. Yeah, ערל. Il aura les dents pures. What is that? And he said, "Où mettons mes gants? Chez lui, il y a où un avis." Eliyahu Hanavi. See, it'd be the translator. I'll help you. Mitorgeman Lashon Targum. Mitorgeman, c'est le même mot que Targum. What is Targum? Aramaic.
Yes.
What is the translation? It's not to speak French or English. To say it in Aramaic. So it's not impure. Because of his mouth, because the language we use cannot be listened in the back. We have to do that? Yes. But in Akkadisha, this one want to put the Aramaic in the Amida, right? Hey. Look.
שלא היה אליהו הנביא, והוא חי וקיים, he's alive and now. Mean who will say it's Moshe? Eliyahu. He never died. He never the face, the sound, the smell of his master. It was Pinchas.
No, it's not Moshe.
Ah.
Oh.
You get it? וזה סוד פסוק פנחס בן אליעזר בן אהרון הכהן וזה לסוד אם צריך לאליה איד so basically what I'm telling you just to be humble as Moshe you have to be powerful and very strong in the kedusha of your brit milah and this will bring you to be able to see success no defeat you will success never call it success but defeat and after the final tikkun is to fix that mistakes that they did one part of the people of Kush to refuse to be led by the best ever de refuser d'avoir de détirer par le meilleur 40 is good but what are 40 is compared to baruch adonai amen ve amen
can you just follow that up really quick